is up, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. This video is vlog number 6, and it's about 5 things I don't like about my Honda Civic, or 5 things I don't like about owning a Honda Civic. If you know me, then you know that I'm an OG. I'm old dude. I'm not one of the young kids out here. I've been doing the Honda thing since middle school. Started off with EFs, getting into those, and then my sisters and hanging out with the Filipino crews. They got all into the EG hatches, coupes. A lot of them were DX bodies with no sunroof, no power windows, and do GSR swaps, or you know, other types of swaps or turbo them or anything like that. So starting off with the first thing I do not like about owning a Honda Civic. So number one, the first thing is the rep we get because of all the Honda boys out here that go out and rev up on everyone and consistently making us get into that stereotype of being part of them, being that type of car guy. And that's probably the most thing that I hate about it, is getting that rap, because every time somebody sees me, they're always either trying to race me or trying to rev up on me or trying to have their block off, go off on me. And it happens every single time. So like yesterday when I went to the store and somebody had one of those Genesis, he saw me and I can see him get all excited in his car, and he was making a right turn and he gunned it just to let the blow off valve go off onto me. And I get that all the time. I get it all from the SRT guys that want to room with me, all the Hellcats. And like I said, I drive this. Come on. So this car is, you know, it needs body work, needs paint. It needs a lot of love. So, and I still get it. And I know, I'm pretty sure it's because, you know, carbon fiber hood. You know, the seats, when they see me driving it, the lip, fog lights, headlights, all that other aftermarket stuff. And that what comes to number 2. So the safety of owning a Honda Civic is everybody wants to steal your car because you have all these aftermarket parts. So I have carbon fiber hood, I have city lights, city daytime running lights, you know, amber marker, aftermarket lip, NK wheels, JDM interior. So, you know, I got JDM center console. You know, I got my gauges that let me know what's going on with the car for maintenance wise, shifter, my seats, and especially my JDM back seats, which are worth actually going for $1,700. So, and these are the SIR seats, so they don't have these. You're not gonna find them no more, so that's why they're super rare. Carbon fiber trunk that is faded, and you know, just aftermarket stuff. Like I have a rear suspension upgrade, so that's the other thing about owning a Honda, is everybody wants to steal your car. Like I have the hub, I have the clutch, foot clutch that I put there on the lock when I have to park somewhere like this. And so that'll be part 2. Number 3 is no power. So this is just straight up daily maintenance for getting to work, point A and point B. Like the only thing I did, like I said, was radiator, all new hoses, and that's pretty much it. Canon air filter. It's nothing. The car was always used for gas and, you know, maintenance to getting into, get to work, get to the bay, do what I need to do. And I've been keeping all my maintenance, but somehow these hoses, I don't know if it's the clamps or what, but I'm still leaking fluid. And I just need to go to Randy's and have him put that pressure test thing here again and pressurize it and see where it's leaking from, because I thought he fixed it, it's still leaking. So I'm guessing I may have to cut this and connect this hose so everything's back to stock, so I can move that over here, but I can't do that because I need to get a swim fan. But like I said, this is the maintenance daily driven motor I have. So power wise, there's no power. That's why everyone that runs me, and I'm not the type to where I say, oh, I got this, I got that. No, I'd let them know, like, dude, I'm stock 1.5 non-VTEC. And when I, and like I said, if you follow me on the channel, then you know that a Civic Type R swap Civic, where I have the power. So that's why I'm not worried about when people rev up on me, because I have a motor, I have a swap. But if you are a beginner YouTube, your income, your money is based on what you make. I currently don't have a job. YouTube is technically my full-time business at the moment. So yeah, so that swap is not happening yet until I get a job, get money, or get more subscribers and get more views and comments and likes. But yeah, so that's part three of what I don't like about my car is no power. But like I said, I do like it because it's great on gas. Number four of what I don't like about owning a Civic is I don't fit. I'm 6'5", and I have to put aftermarket seats and aftermarket rails, so the seats sit lower. If I put stock seats in here, I don't fit. My head hits the ceiling. Like I said, this is my view. If I use the visor, you're not gonna see nothing. So even having this rear view mirror when I'm driving, I look here, this is my view. So when I look here, you don't see nothing over here. So when I'm at a four-way stoplight, I have to look down and then look to the sides for my safety. And also being tall and big, is I didn't get this just so people can't steal my car. That was a plus. I got this because when I have my steering wheel in, I have no room to getting in and out of the car. So I have to use this. Here, I have to take the steering wheel out just to get out of my car. So being big is not great for if you're into the Honda Japanese cars. I don't fit in an S2000. I do fit in an NSX, the older ones. Civic hatchbacks, like, you can't sit behind me. There's no room. Like, you would have to spread your legs like you're having a baby. Like, there's no room in the back seat. So that's why with this car, once I get, you know, the funds and get a job and get going again, then yeah, I'll start doing things in here in the interior, because I want my roll cage. I don't want people sitting in the back. This will be just for me, for driving on the weekends and car meets and stuff. So like I said, but this is not an ideal car for daily wise for someone like me. It is works good because I am single. I have a reliable engine. Commuting wise, this would be okay, but having a back issue doesn't help at all. So that would be number four of what I don't like about owning a Honda Civic. So yeah. And as you can see, I'm actually home now. So I left the building because you can hear the muscle car start coming and acting up. So I didn't want to be in that situation, because pretty sure the cops are going to single me out of those cars. So I left, went and got some potatoes. I'm actually making a baked potato right now. But for number five on my Civic that I don't like is suspension. My shocks and springs are... My My springs are tin. My shocks are Takiko Blues. And they were great when I first got it. Handle fine, perfect, everything. But because they're so old, what, 10, 11 years old now? So when I got those, they did their part. I fell asleep at the wheel, and I rode on the side of the freeway, the median that separates oncoming cars. I fell asleep on the driver's side and drove up on it and slammed down, which caused damage to my front suspension, where it sits a little bit lower. I'm not sure if you guys can see when you see the car, but it sits a little bit lower on the driver's side. That's why my mud guard for my driver's side, front driver's side, got torn off every time that I'm going over speed bumps or anything. Even when I'm coming up on the driveway, my lip will get torn off from the sidewalk, even coming at an angle. But just to show you guys what happened when I was driving my car, I'm just gonna use this as the side of the median of the wall where you're driving on the freeway. So I was driving, fell asleep, and literally swerved like this and drove up on it. And then, boom, hit it and pulled off to the emergency lane or emergency slow lane. And that's what happened with the Civic. So if you ride with me in my passenger seat in the front, everything goes lower because the shocks are pretty much starting to go. So we will scrape on going on curbs and everything so that I can't take people really in my car. If I take anyone, it's always one person in just the front seat. So that would be number 5. And, you know, mostly everything that I don't like can be fixed. So I just got to work on my car and handle it. But like I said, need money. So like I said, I don't have... You know, I don't kick it with famous YouTubers where I get their subscribers and I'm getting YouTube paychecks. So I'm doing this all on my own. I have my Type R in the garage that's literally sitting here collecting dust. So yeah, I even have brand new NRG hub, quick release, and racing steering wheels just sitting there on top of the car. So yeah, that's what's going on with that. So I need to, once I get back on the, you know, on how everything's going, I can be able to work on my Civic and get it to where I always wanted one since high school. Like I said, I've been doing this since wanting to do this since high school, but you know, when you come from a family that doesn't have money, it's something that just doesn't happen. You have to go out and get it and do it yourself. And that's what I've been doing. So, yeah. So that's the situation with the five things I do not like about my Honda Civic. So, all right, y'all. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and put this back. I'll see you guys in episode vlog number 7. So, all right, y'all. Peace. Good night. Have a good night. I'm about to eat this big potato. I'm freaking hungry. Peace.